Hello everybody, welcome to my channel. It's Eva from Bohemian Crafting and today I'm coming with recycling. I've got few those cardboard boxes, those papers which are coming in those cardboard boxes to protect items I'm ordering mostly from Amazon. I've got here bottle from a milk and I've got here few cans already prepared for some work, and I was thinking to create a book using these items and one old book. So all these items and the rest will be glue, some dies, and probably my sewing machine to make some decorative element, and that's it. So first, and also, yeah, of course, I'm gonna use envelopes because I love to use envelopes in Minecraft. So that will be items I will use, and hopefully I will create some beautiful book. So first what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna use my envelopes and create some inserts, two types, not so many inserts, something easy. So I'm gonna glue those envelopes to make it nice and strong. Not there. One. Now I'm gonna cut three sides of those envelopes. One envelope, I'm gonna cut these two short and one long. Just those edges, just open that envelope. And here, the bottom. And the other one I'm gonna cut the opposite way, those two long sides and one short one. So this envelope can be opened this way, and that previous envelope can be opened this way. I'm gonna take my scoring board and yeah, this. I'm gonna make just one score line from the original fold, 2 inches here. Come here. Yeah, come on. So I do have one fold here. That's it. Yes. So now I'm gonna distress all these edges. I'm gonna use walnut stain. And I'm not gonna make any complicated distressing. I'm just gonna slide it all over my distress ink. From all sides, even inside of those envelopes. I saw this. Like this, and now that at the envelope, just really very fast distressing, because I'm gonna use those book pages to decorate those envelopes anyway, so it doesn't have to be some complicated distressing. They've got those two envelopes. And I'm going to take first this with that fold. I'm going to take the book, if I will know where I place it. There you go. Here is my book. I'm going to rip off a few pages. I think I can cut that bottom part. Like this. And my envelope, it's 4 1/4. So I'm gonna cut pieces 4 inches. And I'm gonna open that envelope. And one piece I'm gonna place here on this side. Like this. One piece I'm gonna place on that opposite side. And one piece I'm gonna place on that back side of that envelope, just to make it a little bit stronger. Like this. I've got here my coffee, so I need to move it. Because I'm gonna use a sewing machine, and with my sewing machine I'm gonna make sewn effect all around of this envelope, all this around, just with that normal straight stitching, just to add there something. So I made sewn effect all around of that envelope and one stitched line here, right next to that fold. And now I'm gonna sew it on those three sides, here, here, and here, to make here kind of pocket. So it should be just quick, but you never know. So I do have the base done. I've got here beautiful pocket entry for some tack, and here that top I would like to decorate somehow. So I think right now will be good time to take my cans. I made this book plate using one can which I glued on cardstock. Now I'm gonna take, and I used Sizzix Originals die. It's called book plate. All informations will be down below. This is Sizzix Originals book plates. There are three types of these book plates. And it's kind of, you know, in that style, like Bix Sizzix, you can cut even thick material, which is good. So I've got this book plate. I've got here a few pieces, few those offcuts. So I'm gonna cut one piece. It was 2 inches, so 1 3/4, I guess. 1 7/8. Hopefully. A little bit more. 1 3/4 by 3 3/4. And that should work. Yes, that will fill this space. So I'm gonna place it right here. Like this. I could hear a few words. So which one I can take note? I like that. Yeah, take note. I'm gonna use this take note words like decoration. And I'm gonna glue it down. Somewhere in the middle, like this. Ish. Eh. Come on, stay there. Stay. And on the top, I'm gonna try to glue my book plate from Cannes. So this is my first insert to my book, and I'm gonna show you what I'm gonna do with that second envelope. Again, I'm gonna take those book pages and I'm gonna just glue them to my envelope. One here. And one on that opposite side. Like this. And maybe here. Yeah, where is that flap of that envelope glued down? I'm gonna put their book page as well. Here. Like this. And again, I'm gonna sew it all around on all those sides and here inside as well. Just simple sewing, just to add there something, you know, some decorative element. So I did that sewn effect all around like this. I'm gonna take envelope punch board from VR Memory Keepers and I'm gonna choose which one. Maybe I can use it this way. So inside will be writing space. Okay, so I'm gonna punch like that. Here on that, if so, here, and three, here, okay. And put it between, that piece between those punches. I think I'm cutting my ruler instead of making cut into that envelope. So I'm gonna take my scissors and cut it with my scissors. That's much better. And this piece. You know, sometimes I'm getting questions why I do from my sons, why I do buy so many tools. But that's why, because then I can use it on paper, on metal, on plastic, on anything I want, and I can change the things I've got around into something, you know, interesting. So I've got that base. And I would like to create something on the top. So I'm gonna take this. This is that paper which comes with parcels mostly. Oh, that was actually good size. Okay. I'm gonna fold it. And I'm gonna put the piece which can fit here on the top of my envelope here to this space that will be. I'm gonna have a look. 3.5, yeah, 3.5 inches. That will fit nice. So I'm gonna cut 3.5 piece. 3.5 here. And I would like to have the top part of this opening something a little bit longer, a little bit shorter than the bottom part. So I'm gonna cut both same first to make that something, you know, something interesting. And this will be probably on the top. So this I'm gonna cut a little bit shorter. I guess. Now I've got here the can opener, which I changed to closure using book page and one fastener. Here is the can opener and I want to use it. So here, yeah, I guess this should be okay. So what I've got, it's folded piece of that paper from parcels. This is that longer side. I'm gonna fold those corners together and I'm gonna cut it like a tack, like this. I'm gonna take my book pages and I'm gonna not that way. That will probably doesn't work. And I'm gonna use the book pages to make it a little bit more stronger and also a little bit more interesting. I'm gonna leave small frame using that book page all around. Like this. And I'm gonna take second book page And I'm just gonna slide it inside. And I think this one, yeah, it can be with the frame around as well. Here. Oh, come on, go there, go there, go there. Like this. Glue it together. And I'm gonna cut that book page around as well. Will use now my sewing machine and make a sewing effect, I guess. Yes, I'm gonna make some sewing effect on this small piece. Something just you know, something easy. Nothing too complicated. So first I'm gonna sew on that tuck on the bottom. So I did sewing effect all around. And what I'm gonna do now, I've got here from Cannes, cut this beautiful reinforcer. It's from collection Planners Essentials, I think, Planner Essentials. I will put name of those dies. There is 10 dies, different dies of reinforcers, and they work really well, really beautifully, even with those Cannes. So they are very strong, and they are just those tinless dies, 10 different. And I've got here, this is just circle reinforce, which I made using my paper punches. I'm gonna place it somewhere here, I guess. It will make, you know, it will reinforce that book page and that paper and make nice space for my closure. And I'm gonna fix that closure here. Just like this. Press it down. And now I'm gonna take my envelope and I'm gonna glue all this on that envelope. You can use it like another pocket, but I think this time I'm gonna go just with, you know, just with glue it all the way on my envelope. Glue it down, just like this. So what I've got here, it's opening space, writing space here, and also, stay there, stay glued. Also opening space here. Here it's space maybe for some stickers, space for writing. So I've got that base. And I've got that another one. And I made 6 of each. These a little bit different way. Here I put book page on the top, so the writing space is inside. And I've got 6 of each. And now I'm gonna make the book cover and something what will hold my inserts. And now we're gonna make some holders for those inserts. So But I have noticed that the book page, it's a little bit longer than is my insert. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna make a holder using that book page. But because that book page is so fragile, I'm gonna use one of these, you know, papers from those parcels to reinforce that book page and make some beautiful frame around. And I will use again sewing machine to do just simple stitching like decoration. Shoot, it's gluing now. So I'm gonna place it here, I think that way. That way. Stay. And I'm gonna cut small frame around of that book page. I think like this. Like this and like this and that ish. So that will be my base. Now that sewing effect. So I'm gonna take my sewing machine again. And this time I'm gonna use that zigzag stitching. Where is that number? Here. So I do have that zigzag stitching all around. I'm gonna fold it half. Fold it half. Yeah. Oh, come on. That's not too hard to fold it half. And I'm gonna, with straight stitching, to sew just this edge and that bottom edge. So I'm gonna make kind of pocket. Here and here. Just this, and of course I will have to make 12 of them because I've got 6 inserts of each, so they will hold my inserts this way, all of them, like this. And I need to prepare some front cover and back cover and then put it together. So from those covers, I cut from those cardboard boxes 4 pieces. 2 are 9 1/4. I'm gonna just check it out if I did it. Yeah, 9 1/4 by 4 1/2 are those 2, and those other 2, they are a little bit smaller, so they are 9, yes, 9 by 4 1/4, yes. And to make them to look nice, I'm gonna use this paper from those parcels, and I'm gonna wrap each of these papers separately. And then put them together to make some nice, beautiful cover. Although I can also, bear with me, I'm gonna place it here. I'm gonna take one of these smaller ones. One will be on back side, on back cover, so that can be full. And on front cover, I can make a frame. You're gonna be here. You can be here. There. Gonna give it a try. I'm gonna take my ruler, and with my ruler I'm gonna make 1 1/4. Yes, 1 1/4 marks from all these sides lines. From one. Yeah, come on. 1 1/4 here, 1 1/4 here. So I'm gonna make a frame. 1 1/4, 1 1/4. Here, and 1 1/4. And 1 1/4 here. Oops. And that inside, I'm gonna try to cut off. Hopefully, I will don't cut my ruler again. It will get smaller and smaller and smaller. Here, shouldn't be too hard because it's just normal cardboard box. These are kind of soft and easy to cut usually, but we never know, right? I'm gonna go with my knife through all these layers one more time. Yeah, like here. Who will get that? Here. Go there. And move yourself, nicely. And here. Good. So I do have a frame. Now I need some scissors. Glued my frame on that paper. I will try to make some beautiful frame. So from here, here, here to this corner and the last corner. And I'm gonna give it a try. Stay there. To fold it nicely around the edge. And glue it to my frame here, the opposite side. Like this. Kind of pulling. Pulling, I think it's the right word. The paper using it, that, you know, that smush, smush, smush. Moving. I'm not sure how to say that. This smush, smush, smush. It's kind of pulling carefully that paper around the edge of that frame. And it should sit nicely. Like this. And I'm gonna finish those other parts here, other sides, and I'm gonna wrap all those other pieces to that paper. Here, I think it's too long. Here. Here. Pull around the edge like this. Pull to make sure it sits nicely. Pull. And I do have beautiful frame like this. And I do have also all these wrapped and glued. I would like to cover those covers with some painting to make them a little bit stronger. So what I'm gonna choose is I think, yeah, my shoe polish, to which I add also a little bit of black acrylic paint, and I'm gonna paint it with this and let it dry, all of them, probably from both sides. Definitely from both sides. So when I will have all that done to paint it, this was previously brown shoe polish, but I added that black acrylic paint. So now it's kind of between. You will see once it will dry. So it's all dry. It looks like this. It's kind of between black and brown. And for that top part, that top window, I'm planning to use book page, and I made using this Wonderwort and using this die from metal, from can metal to make a title for my book. But before I will glue it together, I'm gonna use another my tool or supply. This is from Prima Marketing, that Opal Magic Wax, I think it's wax, vintage silk is this one, and it makes really beautiful effect on this dark color here. I already use it a little bit, so I'm gonna use it on all these edges. Just to make those highlights. just very lightly on those edges. And the last one, do the same. Gonna make it from both sides, this one, because it will be seen from both sides, those edges, like this. And now I'm gonna glue it. Oops, I need to tidy up my fingers and my table, just bear with me. Oh, I'm so cold. Okay, so I'm gonna cut this paper. I think somewhere here. And how far? Not done. So somewhere here, I guess it will be okay. I'm gonna put the glue from the side. And try to place that book page the way that I can see. Yay! Come here. Can see the table. Yes, just like this. Yes, just like this. Mm-hmm. And I think I just lost the title. Oh no, it's here. Found it. So here I'm gonna put a glue on all that piece. And place it right here. And I'm gonna let it dry, because now I'm gonna try to put those holders, my page holders, somehow together. So these are my covers for that book. And now it's time to put those holders together and glue them to the cover. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take one of these holders and I'm gonna use this sport tape to put it all together. So first what I need to do is glue the sport tape about halfway to one piece, like this, press it down, here, cut it off, like this, and to make my book easy to open or flexible with a nice space to add there some more things, I made for myself kind of tool. I glued together using that clear packing tape two bamboo sticks. Now I'm gonna place that my new tool. I'm gonna call that spacer because it makes space. Here on the edge of my one entry, here is the entry, here is that entry to that holder, here is the fold, and I'm gonna take another one, and with that fold I'm gonna place it here, and I'm gonna try to match the bottom one and the top one together to make it kind of even. Here, come on, sit down, sit, sit. Oh shoot, here and on the top, and press it this way. I'm gonna take off my amazing tool, that's why I wrap it to that packing tape, because it then it's easy to take it off, and I'm gonna take this sport tape and glue it here. Like this. This is very old technique with, I think ladies before used duct tape for this gluing. I saw it a while ago on some photo album, if I remember that right, that was photo album what I watched 2-3 years ago, I think. And I always wanted to try. So now it's time. So we do have two holders and the kind of spine between. I'm gonna fold it this way so that spine, that do this one, this gap, it's folded around the edge of this pocket. And I'm gonna take my sport tape and glue it here. Press it down, flip it over, put it down here, and put my pockets on the table. Again, I'm gonna take my amazing tool and I'm gonna place it on the edge here. I'm gonna take another pocket and with that fold, I'm gonna place it right here. Like that. Press it down. Take my amazing tool. And again, I'm gonna take sport tape and cover this sticky piece with that sport tape. I'm gonna cut off the sport tape here to make it nice and straight, if it will be possible. Hey! Like this. So we do have, it's starting to make that flexible spine. We do have three pages. So now I'm gonna move all that stuff and fold it around this front pocket. And I'm gonna take this sport tape again, and again, same system, glue down halfway over the edge. Cut it off. And I guess now I can do it even without my amazing tool, hopefully. Keep space. I guess this one will be good. I'm gonna give it a try and I will see how creepy shape I will get. If it will be very bad, I'm gonna call it Halloween book. Like, it's scary, you know, those Halloween houses, they are like not straight. So I'm gonna call that Halloween book. If it will go well, it will be good. And again, I'm gonna take this sport tape and cover this sticky part with it. Just like that. And cut it off. And this way I'm gonna continue with all 12 of these pieces. So I do have all those pages glued together. Here I made kind of mistake. I placed them too close together. But here I've got beautiful spaces. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna move it. This is front and this is last page. So I'm gonna move it this way. All folded around the, you know, bottom of this page. And I'm gonna do actually exactly the same with editing all these pages to a cover. So it's gonna be here. Flip it over, cut it down, like this. So here will be glued one of those larger pieces. Which one is larger? I have to check it out. This is larger. This is larger. Okay. So I'm gonna take one that large piece, and this I wanna have inside. So it will go just like that. I'm gonna flip it over. Put the cover with that fully covered piece, and I'm gonna glue it down. I'm gonna try to keep there some space. And of course, I will use then inks, and I will color all these spaces. But right now, I need to fix it all together. So I'm gonna take another piece, and I'm gonna glue it from this side. Like this. I need to flip it over to see what I've got here. Take my scissors and cut. I'm gonna take my bone folder and I'm gonna try to press it properly all together. So this will be my back cover. Here I've got a piece bigger. Before I will glue one of those smaller pieces here and make some, you know, some kind of framed cover. I'm gonna take walnut stain distress ink. And with that walnut stain distress ink, I'm gonna go on these edges. And here. And because I used black ink or black color mixed with that brown for my cover, I'm gonna add here a little bit of black ink. And now I can glue this. So I'm gonna add that glue. This is that smaller piece. And I'm gonna place it right here. Just like this. So it makes kind of frame all around, and here as well. And same will be with that front cover. I'm gonna move everything this way. I'm gonna place the sport tape here. Press it down. Got this. So here is the smaller part which will come on the top. And here is what will come to inside. I want to have this one inside of my book. So I need to place it this way. I'm going to flip this. And I'm going to flip this. And just glue it down with some small space. Like this. Good. I'm gonna take another piece of that sport tape. And I'm gonna cover that sticky part over there. these properly. Flip it over. Okay. This spot tape is really nicely sticky. Cut it and make it nice and straight with my scissors. Oh, come on. Hold. Here. And it looks good on the other side. And now I'm gonna press it on both these sides to make sure it holds. And I'm gonna use that walnut stain and black ink again. I think here I'm gonna cut this off because it will don't hold the glue. And a little bit of black. Okay. So it will be open this way. I'm gonna put the glue here. And glue it on that cover. You know, you can make so many decorations on that cover. This is just super simple. Like this. Press it down. Like this, and I'm gonna use a walnut stain and a little bit of that black ink, and I'm gonna also distress this spine to match it all together. And this is my recycled book. So we have cover. If I will continue to decorate this, I will totally put here some decorative paper, maybe book page. I will put here some opening, but you know, for now it's done. I've got holders for my small pockets where I can place something inside and give it back. I've got here pockets with those writing spaces. And by the way, I used Tim Holtz Bic Sizzix die, teeny tabs and dies. You can get small pieces like this, and I tried on that milk bottle, and it makes beautiful penny tacks. So I'm gonna add them to these reinforcers, just like this. I did just one, so I'm gonna continue with that. So I've got 12 pages with 12 inserts, and I've got here those small mini notebooks with pocket, and I will decorate it a little bit more, but this is just, you know, to show you that fully recycled book. It's easy to do, and that's why I'm buying my tools, because it gives me chance to do something, right? Even here I didn't use too many tools, like super tools. I use just these dies. So, this is my sharing for today. I hope you did enjoy it. I hope you're gonna try to scrap home waste. And you will create some beautiful journal. Have a wonderful day. Thank you so much for sharing your time with me today. and see you next time. Bye.